Hello friends, today we are going to study about introduction to algorithms. What are algorithms? What are the various factors that affect algorithms? What are the features of algorithm and how the performance of algorithm is designed and how it affects the programming paradigm? Now, to start with, let us start what is an algorithm. In a simple English language, algorithm is defined as a step-by-step procedure of solving a problem. Now, what do you mean by a step-by-step procedure of solving a problem? Given any problem statement, we will divide or we will break that problem statement into small steps that will give us an ease to solve that particular problem. And an algorithm is also defined as a special method usable by the computer for solving a problem. But we have to also take care that computer by itself cannot solve a problem. So we have to design a steps which will be used by the programmers to design in coding so that computer can give us a desired output. These are very simple definitions of an algorithm. In technical words, an algorithm is defined as a sequence of instructions for solving a problem, that is, for obtaining a required output from any valid input in a finite amount of time. We have to be very careful with the time factor, as the amount of time a program takes to give us a desired output, the relevance of it is very important. Now, when we have studied what is an algorithm, now let's see how the data flow for this algorithm happens. Before designing an algorithm, we should have what is known as a problem. Now, what is a problem? A problem can be any real world problem or any small instance from a real world for which we need to design a program or a set of instructions. For this problem, we design an algorithm. An algorithm will be the simple step-by-step procedure. After we have designed this algorithm, we will give the required and the desired input. These required inputs will then be given to the processing unit, and processing unit will give us the desired output, and this output will then be taken as an effective instance of what my algorithm does for the real world problem. All this taken together designed a complete data flow of how my algorithm works. Now, after seeing how my data flow for an algorithm works, let's see why study an algorithm, because this is a question which is going to arise in everyone's mind, that we can write a program directly. Why do we study an algorithm, and how does an algorithm affect the performance of my program? The first major step for designing an algorithm is, algorithm helps us to understand the scalability. Now, what do we mean by the term scalability? When I have a real world problem which is very large, and when the problem is very large, I need to scale it down so that I can get a desired output, or I can get a perfect output which will help me analyze and solve a problem. Now, when I am able to scale a problem into small steps, it will give me the variation that what all important factors and points that I need to consider. And second important step is the performance. And performance will help me to draw the line between what is feasible and what is impossible. Now, any real world problem is not easily or cannot be very easily broken down into small steps. If I am able to break down my problem definition and statements into small, small steps. That means my problem is feasible and it can have finite set of outputs. That is, it was not impossible to solve that particular problem. And algorithm for mathematicians is a way or a structure to provide a language for talking about the program behavior. The many such instances where we use many mathematical steps to solve a problem, so algorithm provides us an outline structure for the same. And the lesson for the program performance generalized for other computing resources. Now, what do I mean by the term computer or computing resources? Computing resources means while I am designing a problem or while I am breaking down that real world problem into small, small logical steps, what all are the other resources, other programming structures that I need? All these things are important steps that we need to know why it is important to study algorithms. And the speed at which a designer can code that particular problem statement is fun. So to bring all to one conclusion that if my algorithm is designed perfectly, speed is fun for the tester and the designer. Now, we have seen why do we need to study algorithms and how it affects the performance. Now, these are the few factors that we need to consider before designing an algorithm. The first and the foremost important feature is modularity. What do you mean by the term modularity? Modularity means when a problem statement is given to me and I can break down it into a small, small modules or small, small steps, as which is a basic definition of my algorithm, then that particular feature of my algorithm is perfectly designed. If I can break it down into small, small modules or steps or into small, small structures. The second is correctness. What do you mean by the term correctness? For any real world problem, when we have a set of inputs which give me a set of outputs, from the desired inputs, when I get a required desired outputs, which means that my algorithm is designed correctly and I have done all my analysis for designing an algorithm in a right manner. If the desired input is given but my logic developed is not right, it will not give me a correct output. So when I'm breaking down using modularity, the correctness of my program and my algorithm should always be maintained. The third step is maintainability. Now, what do we mean by maintainability? Now, the question will arise, how do I maintain an algorithm? Now, algorithm can be maintained in a very simple structured way that when it is used or when it is redefined, it is very, very easy to redefine it. And when I redefine, there are no major changes that need to be done. That is meant by the maintainability of an algorithm. Then is the major and the important factor is the functionality. The functionality considers of the logic, the various logical steps and the criteria that we will study while designing an algorithm to solve the real world problem. Basic logic statements should not be complicated to design the functionality. The other important factor is the robustness of my algorithm. How clearly, how eco-friendly and how friendlily it can define my problem. Robustness also gives us the complete functioning criteria of my algorithm. The important step I said is user-friendliness. Now, what do you mean by the term user-friendliness? If I have designed an algorithm and that algorithm is given for the programmer to code it, if it is not user-friendly, then I will not be able to explain to the designer how it has to be coded. So my algorithm has to be very user friendly. Programmer time, as I said, the algorithm designed by me will be used, or by us, will be used by a programmer. It should not take a lot of time of that programmer. Simplicity, if it is very, very simple, it is easy to understand. If it is easy to understand, it is easy to code. Extensibility, another major issue. If some other programmer or some other designer wants to use your algorithm in the program, then it should be easily extensible, or your program or your algorithm can be used as one part of the module which can be extended by the programmer. Reliable, if my other programmer is using my algorithm, then it should be so perfectly designed that he can use it and he can trustworthily rely upon it to use it in his code. We have studied the factors that affect an algorithm, or what are the factors that we need to consider while designing an algorithm. Let's study what are the various features that we need to use or consider while designing an algorithm. The first and foremost important feature is finiteness. Now, what do I mean by the word finiteness? It means that my algorithm should terminate in a desired number of steps. It should not go into a continuous looping structure. Now, what do you mean by the term looping structure? Means that my algorithm or my program continuously keep on repeating the same number of steps without giving me the required and the desired output. For this, we have to be very careful while designing an algorithm. And the second step is, or the second feature is, the definiteness. What do you mean by this? It should give me a cleared output picture. That is, whatever is needed for my algorithm, it should be rigorously and unambiguously specified. That is meant by definiteness. Clearly specified input is a very important feature of an algorithm. When I'm designing an algorithm, my steps should be such that all the requirements that are needed for my inputs have to be valid. If I have a valid input which is clearly specified, then my output will also be valid. If my input is valid, as I see, the next feature is given in clearly specified output. If my input is valid and it gives me a specified output, my output also will be very clear and it will give me a precise output. It can be proved to produce the correct output from a given input. Effectiveness. Now, what is meant by the term effectiveness? Steps are sufficiently simple and basic. As we saw in our factors that we have to remember and consider while designing an algorithm, that my algorithms should be simple and user-friendly. If it is simple and user-friendly, then only it can give me an effectiveness in the algorithm. Now, why is algorithm important to us? That is meant by the importance of algorithm that we will be studying in this particular topic. First and foremost importance of algorithm is a theoretical importance. Now, what do you mean by the term theoretical importance? Theoretical importance is when any real world problem is given to us and we break it down, as we saw, the modularity is an important factor. As we break it down, we need to know all the theoretical aspects of it. With this theoretical aspects, we should also consider the practical importance, because a theory is never complete without a practical implementation. So the importance of algorithm is considered both from theoretical as well as from practical importance. When we are writing an algorithm, the steps which will be considered by the designer in practical have also to be considered clearly. With this importance of theoretical and practical, we will see what are the issues of algorithms. The first is, and always comes in everybody's mind, is how do we design an algorithm? As we said,
its algorithm is a step-by-step procedure of solving any problem. So when we design an algorithm, we will follow certain steps. And first thing is, and the second important thing is, how do we analyze the efficiency of an algorithm? Now, efficiency of an algorithm can be designed by and can be derived by various methods that we'll be studying later. Now, we will see what are the different approaches to design an algorithm. These approaches are used after considering the various factors, the theoretical importance and the practical importance of designing an algorithm. The first one is known as brute force. Now, brute force, the term by itself means that we do it in a random way. We apply a general logical structure to design an algorithm. All these approaches, these are just listed down over here, will be discussed in details later. Second one is divide and conquer, which is a very simple implementation or a very simple definition of saying that I divide my algorithm or I repeat or I design my algorithm in a simple step-by-step variations. So divide and conquer gives me to break down my algorithm to solve a problem in different methods. I divide my algorithm into small functions or small procedures, and then for a valid input, when I get a valid output, that output is given as a valid input to another function. This is how my divide and conquer works. The next method is known as decrease and conquer, which is also a similar way to divide and conquer. Here, I reduce my programming technicality by taking an input and output for a function. I decrease the complexity of my program and then I try to solve the problem. Transform and conquer is a fourth important approach for an algorithm. I can transform my algorithm into different approaches, whether it is a top-down or a bottom-up approach that we'll be studying, and then we transform it from one logical reasoning to another logical reasoning, and then we try to solve an issue. Space and time trade-offs are very important, as we have to always consider the time factor for solving and writing a program. If my time factor is not important or not considered, my code can run for a longer time, in which I mean to say that I waste that much space and time of my processing unit. Let's take a simple example of how to write an algorithm. Write an algorithm to add two numbers. Now, it's a very simple mathematical statement that we are learning from kindergarten or from first standard, where we have to add two numbers. Now, how do we add two numbers? This problem statement is divided into following steps. Step 1, input the value of two variables. Let's take an example, A and B. Now, after having two values, A and B, what do we do next? We add those two variables and we store the value in another variable called C. And then it is written as C is equal to A plus B. The third step is display the result and store it in variable C. This is how, to add two numbers, we write a simple algorithm. Thank you.